Kurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
Free bus for LKG to 8th standard.
Free hygienic and nutritious food.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Education Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12th, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12th, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Students, now in this video, we are going to discuss regarding fourth horal. So in a flower, our knowledge point of view, four horals are there, right? So calyx, corolla, andrecium, up to andrecium information. So we have seen in previous videos. So now in this video, we are discussing fourth horal. Fourth horal of a flower is nothing but pistil or the gynecium. After completion of this one, so a very important point, very important information we will observe, we will study in placentation. Okay, now let me explain. Fourth horal of a flower is nothing but gynecium, so arc pistil. So now, so same information only I have written here. Gynecium is the fourth and innermost horal of the flower. So that point we know very well. So we have seen that one. So gynecium is a fourth and innermost horal of the flower. It is female reproductive organ. This particular gynecium we will be considering as a female reproductive organ, and it is composed of one or more carpels. I'm a point you understood. So first of all, what is the point we are discussing? This particular gynecium is fourth and innermost horal of the flower. I'm a point you learn now. Next one, it is the female reproductive organ. Which one? Gynecium. Gynecium is female reproductive organ. Next one, this gynecium is composed of one or more carpels. This gynecium is made up of one or more carpels, means within the gynecium, so one or more carpels are present. So that is the point. Now carpels are also known as megasporophylls. So these are all different types of names. So carpels are also known as megasporophylls. A typical carpel, suppose if you take a particular typical carpel, consists of three parts, such as basal swollen portion is known as ovary. Next one, middle elongated portion is known as style. Next one, apical portion is known as stigma. So here one rough diagram also we can draw, but that particular diagram we know very well in our childhood studies. We have seen which one. Suppose if you take one particular gynecium, definitely that consists of three parts. So style, stigma, ovary. Likewise, in a seventh standard onwards, so definitely in biology books we have learned, we have seen. So there, suppose if you take a particular carpel, that particular consists of three parts. So what are those? Definitely swollen part we will be calling as ovary. Next one, elongated middle part or middle portion we will be taking as style. Next one, apical portion we will be taking as stigma. So this particular stigma only is acting as receptacle for receiving of pollen grains. For receiving of pollen grains, right. Now, ovules develops in the ovary. So here ovary, swollen portion is there, no? In that swollen portion, which one will be there? Ovules. Ovules are developed in the ovary. Next one, style, middle part, junction between ovary and stigma. Don't forget, this particular stigma is acting as receptacle. Receptacle means, so for the receiving of pollen grains. So thereby pollen grains first germinates in the or on the stigma, later grows through the style and finally reach to the ovules which are present in the ovary. So that's why here what is the point I have written, ovules develops in the ovary. So that is the point, right? Now the number of carpels. So number of carpels point of view, based on the number of carpels, gynoecium in angiosperms is of the following types. So first of all, number of carpels information I will give you. So there what is the point now we are going to discuss is, based on the number of carpels, based on the number of carpels, gynoecium in angiosperms is of following types, or is of the following types. Now what are those? Once you see there the table, type of gynoecium, next one number of carpels, next one examples. So there first one more time, type of gynoecium and the number of carpels and example. So there monocarpellary gynoecium, monocarpellary means here how many number of carpels we can see, only one carpel. Best example, Dolichos lablab. Okay, next one, bicarpellary condition. Bicarpellary gynoecium means bicarpellary gynoecium. So there, how many number of carpels are there? Two carpels are present. So best example, Solanum. Next one, tricarpellary gynoecium. Tricarpellary gynoecium means there how many number of carpels are present? Three carpels are present. So best example, Allium sepa. Okay, my Liliaceae family members, Allium sepa. Onion we will study now. Adema, onion scientific name only, Allium sepa. Next one, tetracarpellary gynoecium. So tetracarpellary gynoecium, where we can see now, we can see in Enothera, and tetra means four. Four carpels are present. Number of carpels are 4. Amma point you understood. Next one, pentacarpellary gynoecium. Penta means 5. 5 carpels are present. So presence of 5 carpels we can see in hibiscus. Next one, multicarpellary. Multi means many, no. So that's why multicarpellary gynoecium. So there how many number of carpels are present? Many carpels are present. Many carpels means more than 5. Okay, so best example, abutilon indica. So in our regions, no, abutilon indica, so very familiar, very famous. Once you can observe that, once you type in abutilon, when you will observe that particular plant, no, now you switch off, take your mobile out, keep it out, and once you go to the mark, which one, garden and all, once you try to observe there multicarpellary gynoecium, so you can observe in abutilon indica. Now one more time let me explain, number of carpels point of view, based on the number of carpels, gynoecium in angiosperms is of the divided into following types. So type of the gynoecium, monocarpellary gynoecium. Mono means one carpel is present. Dolichos best example. Bicarpellary gynoecium best example, Solanum. Bicarpellary means total number of carpels 2. Next one, tricarpellary gynoecium. 3 carpels are present, best example Allium. And tetracarpellary gynoecium, 4 carpels are present, example Enothera. Next one, pentacarpellary gynoecium, 5 carpels are present, best example Hibiscus. Next one, multicarpellary gynoecium, many carpels are present, example Abutilon. So this is some more information regarding number of carpels. Okay, so here my dear students, one point you try to save in your mind, that important point, what is that now? So here by covering of a textbook, so I have given information for NEET examinations also. So here, so that's why this much of information, number of carpels, how many are there and what are the examples, this much of huge information are not there in our NCERT, but this particular topic is important for NEET examinations. That's why by referring other books, I'm giving this much of huge information. Suppose if you have capability to study well, otherwise simply forget it, right? Once you see there, fusion of carpels point of view, carpels of gynoecium may remain free or fused. Emma, so what are the carpels or present in the gynecium now? May remain. How? Free or fused. Okay. Now here, based on that one only, whether it is a free or whether it is fused, based on that one. So we have divided carpels into two types. One is apocarpus and one more is syncarpus. Apocarpus point of view. So here let us see apocarpus and syncarpus. Apocarpus free. Emma, next one is syncarpus fused. So this is for understanding point of view I have written. Now one by one now let us see apocarpus gynecium. So there carpels are present on the thalamus remains free. Emma, now what are the carpels are present on the thalamus? Emma, what are the carpels are present on the thalamus remains free? Means or simply apocarpus means carpels are free. So thereby what is the point here we can see now in apocarpus gynecium each carpel has ovary, style and stigma. Emma, so best example apocarpus best example or apocarpus gynecium best example nilambo nucifera and one more is Michaelia. Okay, Nilambo nucifera and one more is Michaelia. Apocarpus examples, neat examination point of view also important. Next one, syncarpus. So next one at syncarpus, what is the point here we can be taken now? Syncarpus, carpels of gynecium are completely fused. Okay, so syncarpus means, so what are the carpels are present in the gynecium now are completely fused. So this kind of thing we can be seen in hibiscus. Okay, means here what are the points to be discussed or to be remembered mainly means apocarpus you try to remember. If you remember apocarpus remaining mostly syncarpus the. Emma, so thereby apocarpus gynecium is nothing but when the carpels are present in the or present on the thalamus suppose remains free. Emma, simply if carpels are remains free, so that kind of condition we will be taking as apocarpus condition. So in this apocarpus condition no, so each gynecium or each carpel has ovary, style and stigma. So this kind of thing or this kind of condition of apocarpus we can see in Nilambo and one more is Michaelia. Next one is syncarpus. Syncarpus means the carpels of gynecium are completely fused. Means what are the carpels are present in the gynecium no? All carpels are completely fused. Emma, so that kind of condition we can be seen in hibiscus. Hibiscus, so that is information. So here we can be seen. Now here, so here what is information here we can be taken means. So here the what is the point? So fusion of carpels point of view and number of carpels point of view. Isn't it? So here number of carpels point of view, here different types we seen monocarpellary, bicarpellary, tricarpellary, tetracarpellary, pentacarpellary, multicarpellary likewise. Next one, fusion of carpels point of view. So fusion of carpels point of view also here we are discussing. So fusion of carpels point of view, so carpels of gynecium may remain free or fused. Emma, so there apocarpus gynecium and one more is syncarpus gynecium. Emma, apocarpus gynecium and one more is syncarpus gynecium. So apocarpus gynecium means, so suppose if the gynecium is free apocarpus gynecium, and suppose if the gynecium or the carpels Emma, carpels are fused, that kind of thing we will be calling as syncarpus. Syncarpus. So thereby one is apocarpus, there the carpels present on the thalamus will be remains free. Next one, syncarpus, what are the carpels of a gynecium? Definitely fused. Emma, so best example hibiscus. Next one, so very very important concept in a female reproductive system, that is placentation. Emma, placentation. So in placentation what are the main important points to be discussed means, so here the placentation is divided into many types. Okay, so before start to discuss about the many types, so first let us see what is placentation. Okay, so there the ovary consists of one or more ovules. So this is the first point in placentation. Ovary consists of one or more ovules. So definitely, suppose if you take one ovary, there one or many ovules we can see. Emma, next one, the part of the ovary that bears ovules. The part of the ovary that bears ovules means what is a part that bears the ovules? No, that one we can be taken as placenta. Placenta. Now, placentation means the mode of arrangement of ovules in the ovary. Amma, so on the placenta is referred as placentation. Point you understood means here the mode of arrangement of ovules within the ovary on the where? On the placenta is referred as placentation. So now you say, try to say along with me, that is the mode of arrangement of ovules. So on the placenta within the ovary is referred as placentation. Is referred as placentation. Now this particular placentation is of different types. First one is marginal placentation, second one is axial placentation, third one parietal placentation, fourth one free central placentation, and fifth one basal placentation. So now first one is marginal placentation. So this particular marginal placentation, what is the information now? So here the ovary is unilocular. In marginal placentation, first point, ovary is unilocular. Unilocular. So unilocular means here how many locules are present? Only one locule is present. Next one, the ovules are born on this ridge ventral suture of the ovary. So this particular point is important. In marginal placentation, ovules are definitely born on the ridge ventral suture of the ovary. So ridge ventral suture of the ovary, so definitely so involves in the formation of ovules. So that is information only. And the ovules are born on this ridge, forming the two rows as in the P as well as dolichos. In marginal placentation, what are the points to be discussed? Means ovary is unilocular. Next one, ovules are born on the ridge ventral suture of the ovary. So ridge ventral suture of the ovary, don't forget, important. Definitely ovules are born on the ridge ventral suture of the ovary. So this kind of marginal placentation we can see in P and dolichos. So thereby, did you remember one point? P and dolichos, all the time in each and every examples we are taking only now. So already I told you these P and dolichos members or belongs to the family is Fabaceae. Okay, ma, next. So here once you see this particular diagram down, so here we have seen this kind of arrangement or this kind of seeds before. Means suppose dolichos and the P, if you see there, no, the arrangement of a pod will be like this. So there, while while cooking, no, mummy will separate the, so these two things means here the ventral suture, if you see there, no, this particular ventral suture of the ovary bears the or bear which one ovules inside. So this is the best diagram of the marginal placentation. Next one, axial placentation. Second one, axial placentation. In axial placentation, no, in this the ovules are attached to the central axis. Emma, ovules are attached to the where central axis present in the, and so thereby when ovules are present on the central axis, no, present in the bilocular to multilocular ovary. So this kind of central placentation, Emma, or this kind of axial placentation, how? So here this one central axis present where and where? Bilocular to multilocular ovary. Emma, so thereby, so suppose if the ovules are attached to the central axis, attached to the central axis present in the bilocular and multilocular ovary. So this kind of axial placentation, so we can see in hibiscus tomato and lemon. So what are the examples are there in the NCERT? All examples I have taken along with the NCERT examples. So some other new examples also I have given here. So thereby in Excel presentation, what is the point you have to remember means ovules are attached at the or attached to the central axis. So best examples are hibiscus, tomato and lemon. Next one, parietal placentation. So in parietal placentation, this one NEET examination point of view important, so try to listen carefully. So in parietal placentation, ovules develops on the inner wall of the ovary. Once you see there, so here this is outer wall and inner wall. So this is exactly at spotlight we are finding inner wall. So ovules are attached or ovules are developed from the inner wall of the ovary. Inner wall. Suppose if the ovules are developed from the inner wall of the ovary, so that particular placentation we can be taken as parietal placentation. Now here what are the main important points? No, ovary is one chambered ovary, but it becomes two chambered due to the formation of false septum. Ovary is one chambered, but it become two chambered due to the formation of false septum. So this particular statement also is important for NEET examination point of view. So in parietal placentation, one chambered ovary only is present, that becomes a two chambered ovary due to the formation of false septum. So suppose if the false septum formation takes place, so thereby the number of chambered will be increased. Parietal placentation. So in parietal placentation we can observe formation of false septum. So parietal placentation best examples are mustard and one more is argemone. So mustard and argemone, these two are best examples of parietal placentation. Excel placentation diagram also once you see. So this is the diagram of Excel placentation. So here once you see there, the ovules, each and every ovules or the ovules are the separated by means of a line. No, this particular line we will be taking as septa. So once here you see there, konja information I will give you important points. So here this particular line we will be taking as a septa. Now here this particular line, so now separates the ovules. Separates the ovule. So now here from one line to another line. So from here to line, this particular part, once you see in the diagram. So this particular part we will be calling as carpel. So means here how many lines I have drawn here? 1, 2, 3. So thereby this entire particular ovary divided into 3 carpels. That's why this particular thing. So diagram of a tricarpellary condition we can be taken. Tricarpellary, but here, so once you see there, one line, so from here to here one carpel. So means now here empty space is there, no? This particular empty space, so we will be taking as a locule. So this one we can be divided into one carpel, and within the carpel, so empty space we will be taking as a locule. So thereby here one important point let me give you, that is number of carpels, total number of carpels is equals to the total number of locules. Try to save this point in your mind. Total number of carpels equals to the total number of locules. So that point, so furtherly also you can learn, right? Now next one, free central placentation. Free central. So when the ovules are born on the central axis, once you see there, so here also ovules are born at the central axis and the septa is absent. Once you see, so here in axial placentation, so here this particular septa is there. No, if you remove this septa later, this one only formation takes place. Once you see there, so what is the difference between second diagram and fourth diagram? So here the septa lines are absent. not there, emma, simply. So that is the thing. So free central placentation, so thereby what is the point here we can save in our mind, means free central placentation is developed from the or formed from the axial placentation. Why? In axial placentation septal lines are there, but in free central placentation lines are not there or lines are absent. That is only no difference, emma. So that is a difference. So thereby sometimes, you know, chances there to ask this kind of statements also. What is that statement? Definitely free central placentation developed from the axial placentation. So what is the difference between axial placentation and free central placentation? Means axial placentation consists of a septa, same septa is absent in free central placentation, but ovules are present, or ovules are attached to the or born on the central axis. It is a common point. The point you understood, right? Next one, in free central placentation, best examples are dianthus and one more is primrose or primrose. Dianthus and primrose. Next one, fifth one is basal placentation. Basal placentation point of view, the placenta develops at the base of the ovary. The placenta develops at the base of the ovary and a single ovule is attached to it. Means definitely placenta develops at the base of the ovary as well as a single ovule is attached to it. Just only one ovule is present. That is also here the placenta develops at the base of the ovary, and so within the ovary how many ovules we can observe? Only one ovule is observed. So this kind of basal placentation we can observe in sunflower. Sunflower scientific name Helianthus sinuosus. Next one, marigold, we know very well. Okay, Tacitus padula. Marigold scientific name is Tadula. So here, so likewise here somewhat information to be discussed regarding which one? Placentation. First of all, placentation is nothing but the mode of arrangement of ovules where on the placenta within the ovary is referred as placentation. So this particular placentation, different types are there. What are the types? Marginal placentation, axial placentation, parietal placentation, free central placentation and basal placentation. In marginal placentation, so definitely unilocular ovary is present. Next one, ovules are present on the ventral suture. Amma, this is the important point. Marginal placentation, best example P and Dolichos, or marginal placentation we can see in Fabaceae family members. Next one, axial placentation. No, so definitely ovules are attached to the central axis. Ovules are present on the or attached to the or bound on the central axis. Next one, axial placentation, best example hibiscus, tomato and lemon. So this particular axial placentation we can see in bilocular to multilocular ovary. Next one, parietal placentation we can see in mustard as well as argemone. So here in parietal placentation, what are the main important points? Means ovules develops in the or on the inner walls of the ovary or peripheral part. Next one, so here thereby one more important point, what is that? Ovary is a one chambered ovary, but it becomes two chambered due to the formation of false septum. Means, my dear students, one important point that we have to remember, that is in comparison of five types, no, formation of a false septum, we are observing only in parietal placentation. So best examples are mustard and one more is argemone. Next one, free central placentation is formed from the axial placentation. So what is the difference between axial and free central? Means in axial septa is present and in free central septa is absent. Septa is absent. So best examples of free central placentation, dianthus, primrose. Dianthus and one more is primrose. Next one, basal placentation we can see in sunflower and marigold. So there, what is information? Placenta develops at the base of the ovary. And consists of single ovule. So thereby 5 types of placentations now we are observing. What are those? Marginal placentation, axial placentation, parietal placentation, free central placentation and basal placentation. So once you check the diagrams and practice the diagrams also, so here. But what is the main important point now I'm giving you is, so this particular video entirely, purely, perfectly only for NEET examinations. Emma, try to watch this video. Suppose if you are facing any kind of problems, no, try to watch this video one or two times. So thereby you will get the knowledge on this. Thank you, Emma. Take care and be safe at home.